Hello children, welcome to AIIMS India's online classes. Today, from mathematics subject, polynomials topic we are going to discuss. So this is the first class of polynomials children. So let's start with introduction. So let us observe two given situations. The first situation is, a flower bed in a garden is in the shape of a triangle. The longest side is 3 times the middle side and smallest side is 2 units shorter than the middle side. Let P represents the length of middle side. What's the perimeter in terms of P? Means they are telling that the flower bed is in the shape of a triangle. Flower bed like this, it is in the shape of a triangle. So they have compared the, this is the middle side, longest side and shortest side. Actually, we have 3 statements here. The longest side is 3 times the middle side. Smallest side is 2 units shorter than the middle side and the flower bed is in the shape of a triangle and P represents length of the middle side. So regarding 3 sides, they have given some hints in 3 statements. P represents middle side, they are telling. Longest side is 3 times of middle side, means 3 times of P. Smallest side is 2 units shorter than middle side, means 2 units less than P, means P minus 2. So according to the above situation, there is an unknown term in each statement. So in the first situation, middle side they have given as P. So if the middle side is P, longest side is 3 times greater than, means it will become 3P. Shortest side is 2 units less than, means it will become P minus 2. Now, what is the perimeter of triangle? Sum of all sides, P plus 3P plus P minus 2. P plus 3P plus P, 5P. 5P minus 2 is the perimeter. 5P minus 2 is the perimeter. This is first situation, children. Now, second situation. The length of a rectangular dining hall is twice its breadth. So, length of a rectangular dining hall compared with the breadth. Let X represents the breadth of the hall. What is the area of the floor of the hall in terms of X? As they have compared length with breadth, if breadth is X, length is twice its breadth, means length will become 2X. Now we have to find the area. In second situation, so length is twice the breadth. Breadth they have given as X, length 2X. Area formula, length into breadth, which means 2X into X. 2X square is the area. Okay. In the first situation, we have got perimeter 5P minus 2. In the second situation, we have got area as 2X square. These two are the examples of polynomials of different degrees. So they have given 2 situations with unknown quantities. The 2 situations we have written in the form of a polynomials of different degrees. So actually, what are these polynomials? If you see the definition of polynomial, so polynomials are algebraic expressions constructed using constants, variables. Constants means the number which will never change their values in any kind of mathematical operation. They are called constants, whose value will be same in all kinds of mathematical operations. They are considered as constants. Variable means, suppose x is greater than 7, What is the value of x? It may be equal to 8, it may be equal to 9, it may be equal to 7, because 3 are greater than 7. Like that, x is open for any value. X is open for any value which satisfies this condition. So, here x value is not constant. So, here polynomials means they are constructed with the help of constants and variables. Now, 5p minus 2, with the help of constants 5, 2 and with the help of variable p, it is constructed. What about 2x square? With the help of constants 2 and in the power 2 and variable x, it is constructed with constant 2, which is the coefficient. Before the variable, whatever term we are having, it is called coefficient. But here, the variable, it doesn't have any power, so we can assume it here 1. Here, variable x, it is having power 2. Means, along with the construction with constants and variables, coefficients also operate on variables. And the variables can be raised to various powers. Variables can be raised to various powers like this. In the variable, we can raise to a power, different powers, to the power of 1, square, cube, to the power of 4, like that. Variable, we can raise to different powers. But the powers should be of non-negative integer. Means, powers should be always positive. Positive exponents. So, polynomial means it consists of constants, it consists of variables, variables operate on coefficients, along with that variable are raised to positive exponents. With all these combination, if we construct any algebraic expression, mathematical expression, then it is called as a polynomial. So, for example, 2x plus 5, 3x square plus 5x plus 6. Here, first two terms. Here, 1, 2, 3. 3 terms. Minus 5y, 1 term. X cube, 1 term. These are all having variables and consonants. And each expression, the variable is raised to positive exponent. So, these are all examples of polynomials. So, whereas 1 by x square is not a polynomial. Why means? 1 by x square means if you take x to the numerator part, it will become x power minus 2. So, x is raised to negative exponent, which is not in the definition of a polynomial. Means in the denominator, if you have variable, then it is not a polynomial. 1 by 2x, denominator variable. 1 by y minus 1, denominator variable. Cubed root of 3x cube means root 3 into root x cube. So root means how can we write? Root 3 into x to the power of 3. Root means whole power 1 by 2. So, x power 3 by 2. So, we will be having x power 3 by 2, which is not an integer, which is a rational number or which will be a fraction, which is not an integer. So, as the exponent is not an integer, this is also not an example of polynomial. If the variable is raised to negative exponents, or variable is raised to rational or fractional exponents, so then they are not polynomials. So here, one by y minus one is not a polynomial means because it is in the denominator part. If it is raised to numerator part, it will be raised to negative exponent. So that's why it is not a polynomial. Next one. State which of the following are polynomials and which are not. Give reasons. 2x cube. It's a polynomial because it is having constant variable raised to positive exponent. 1 by x minus 1. It's not. Y means variable is in the denominator part. If it goes to numerator, it will become negative. Yes, polynomial. Yes, because positive exponent. Here we can have 1 by 7. Constant can be a rational number. It doesn't matter. Only we have to check the exponent of the variable. So m square. Root 2 m. This root 2 does not belong to m. This root 2 is separate. So it is also a polynomial. P power minus 2. It's not a polynomial because negative exponent. So the first one is a polynomial. Second one is not. Third one polynomial. Fourth one polynomial. Fifth one is not a polynomial. So next, degree of a polynomial. Degree of a polynomial. Suppose, actually, every polynomial is named because it's a polynomial in x. It's a polynomial in variable x. It's a polynomial in variable z. It's a polynomial in variable m. So, based on the variable present in the algebraic expression, we name it as polynomial in x, polynomial in y, like that. And we can also assume their names as p of x, q of x, like that. If p of x is a polynomial in x, the highest power of x in p of x is called degree of the polynomial p of x. Suppose that you are having a polynomial in variable x, which is named as p of x. If anybody asks, what is the degree of polynomial? What you have to tell? The highest power of x in p of x is called the degree of polynomial. For example, 3x plus 5. 3x plus 5. It's a polynomial in x. Here, x power is 1. Here, there is no x. If there is no x, we can assume x power 0. Because x power 0 value is 1. 1 into 5 is 5. Value doesn't change. Here, x power is 1. X power is 0. What is the highest power? 1 is the highest power of the variable. So, degree of this particular polynomial is 1. So, its degree is 1. And it is called a linear polynomial or first degree. Linear means first degree, means whose degree is 1, that is called as a linear polynomial. So 5x linear polynomial, root 2 y plus 5 linear polynomial, 1 by 3 p power 1, m plus 1, m power 1, these are all examples of linear polynomials. Means the polynomial of degree 1 is called as a linear polynomial. A polynomial of degree 2 is called as a quadratic polynomial. For example, x square plus 5x plus 4, here power is 2, here power is 1, here power is nothing means 0. So here highest power is 2. So that's why it is a quadratic polynomial in variable x. So now this one. 2x square plus 3x minus 1 by 2 or p square minus 1 minus 3 minus z square. This square term may be in the beginning, may be in the last. But what is the highest power? Here 0, here 1, here 2. So highest power is 2. So y square minus y by 3 plus root 2. These are all examples of quadratic polynomials whose highest degree is, highest power is 2. Next one. So the expression 5x cubed minus 4x square plus x minus 1 is a polynomial in variable x of degree 3 because here power is 3, 2, 1, 0. So highest power is 3. So it is called cubic polynomial. It's a cubic polynomial. So some more examples of cubic polynomials are 2 minus x cubed, p cubed, L cube minus L square plus minus L plus 5, like this. These are all cubic polynomials. Okay. So, in the same way, children, in the same way, try to write three different quadratic, cubic, and two linear polynomials with the different number of terms. So try to frame linear, quadratic and cubic. Each one, 3-3 examples or 2-2 examples, try to frame different types of polynomials. So one thing you have to keep in mind, total algebraic expression should be defined in only one variable. In the first term, if you use x, in the second term, you can use, if you use y, third term z, like that also you can use. But until up to now, we have discussed only the polynomials only with one variable. So that's why try to make them with only one variable. About this having multiple variables in one expression, we will learn later. So we can write polynomials of any degree. So 7 u power 6, 3 by 2 u power 4, 4 u square minus 8 is a polynomial of degree 6. It's called 6th degree polynomial. First degree, second degree, third degree, we are having special names. Linear, quadratic, cubic. After that, based on number of, based on the degree, if it is 4, 4th degree polynomial. If it is 5, 5th degree polynomial. 6, 6th degree polynomial. Now this is a polynomial whose degree is 10. It is called as 10th degree polynomial. Like that, we can write polynomials of any degree. We can write polynomials of any degree. Next year. So we can write a polynomial in a variable x of degree n, where n is a natural number. Suppose we want to write polynomial of nth degree. So if we want to write polynomial of nth degree, so our polynomial name is p of x, it's a nth degree polynomial. Nth degree polynomial means its highest power is n, lowest power is 0. Means if it is in, because the p of x is given, defined in variable x, x power n is the highest power of this polynomial. Before that, we will get one coefficient, let it be a0, a1. X power n minus 1 plus a2 x power n minus 2, because degree is decreasing. First, suppose if you have 5, 5th degree polynomial, what are the variables? What variables will come? X power 5 plus x power 4 plus x cube plus x square plus x plus constant. Like that, normally we have polynomials. So we have, they have given n here, so that's why we have written n first. Next variable, 1 less than n, n minus 1, 1 less than n minus 1, n minus 2, like that we can write. And before constant term we are getting x term, means if it is 5th degree polynomial, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5th term. It will be fifth sum means first coefficient we have taken as a0 here, and fifth term is, so here this is the a0 is the first term, coefficient a1 we have taken for second term, coefficient a2 we have taken for third term. And what coefficient to be taken for constant term? Means it is before term, before constant term. If we have degree 5, we will be having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 terms. If the degree is 5, then in the expansion we will be having 6 terms. If the degree is n, in the expansion we will be having n plus 1 terms. Total terms we will be having n plus 1 terms. For that, coefficients we have taken from a0, a1, a2, like that. We have started with 0. So last one, that constant will become an. Because 0 to n, the number of terms will become n plus 1. So before that one, what will be the coefficient? n minus 1. That will be the x term. After that, Constanta. Like that, we can expand. So here, A0, A1, A2, A power n, An minus 1, An are the real coefficients where this A0 coefficient does not belong to 0, because if it becomes 0, this entire term will become 0 and this there will be no x power n, only x power n minus 1 will be there. It will be, instead of nth degree, it will become n minus 1th degree. Like that it will become. So, Kichanan, like this we can write a polynomial of nth degree. So, by writing polynomial of nth degree, the variable x power starts with n, n minus 1, n minus 2, x power 1, x power 0. Like that all variables with exponents will come. While writing coefficients, as we are starting with a0, a0, a1, a2, last one, an, before that one, an minus 1. Because a2, a1, before a2 we have a1, before a1 we have a0. In the same way, before an, we will be having an minus 1. But here the condition is, a0 should not be equal to 0. So then it won't be nth degree. These are all real coefficients. So based on this form, the first variable, first degree polynomial means, so what we will get? First degree polynomial means P of x equal to a0 x to the power of 1 plus a1 x to the power of 1 minus 1. In the place of a0 coefficient, we are taking a, x power 1 means x. In the place of a1 coefficient, we are taking b, x power 1 minus 1 means 0, x power 0 means 1 into 1, our simplification, ax plus b into 1, b. So, according to this form, because they have mentioned first degree, we will start with this one, this term. We will keep 1 here. For two terms only, it will be stopped, because degree 1 means it will be consisting of two terms. And the general form is ax plus b. Like this, any degree polynomial we can write with the help of this general form. So here ax and b are real numbers, a is not equal to 0. So write a quadratic polynomial, cubic polynomial in variable x in general form. So P of x, quadratic polynomial, a0, quadratic means power 2, next a1, x power 2 minus 1, next a3, x power 2 minus 2, 2 minus 2. Means quadratic polynomial means 3 times. a0, let's say constant x, a, x square, a1, let's say constant b, x power 2 minus 1, x, a3, let's say constant c, x power 2 minus 2, 0, no need to keep. So, ax square plus bx plus c is the general form of quadratic polynomial. In the same way, cubic polynomial means a0, cubic polynomial means starts with cube, a1, x power 3 minus 1 plus a2 x power 3 minus 2 plus a3 x power 3 minus 3. So a0, let's take constant a, x cube plus a1, let's take constant b, x square, a2, let's take constant c, x power 1, a4, a3, let's take constant d, x power 0, no need to mention. So, ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Like this, any polynomial of any degree we can write with the help of general form. So, write a general polynomial of q of z. Means in terms of z we have to write b0, z power n, b 1 z power n minus 1 b 2 z power n minus 2 dash 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 and so on. In the last term will be b n, only constant term. Before that, will that one will be b n minus 1 z, means here z power 0, here z power 1. Like this we can write with coefficients b0 to bn. What are the conditions for b0 to bn? What about these values b0 to bn? They should all belong to real numbers. B0 to bn all should belong to real numbers. That is the condition. Okay, children, that's all for today, children. So remaining concepts we will learn later. Okay, children, thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates. Thank you, children. Have a good day.